Whenever you use this potential relay, always use a good quality relay. If you don't use a good quality relay, your system, compressor, or motor may get damaged quickly. There is also a significant difference in weight between the two relays. Although they appear the same externally, the only visible difference is in size, where one is smaller and the other is larger. Otherwise, their base plates, etc., are identical. When I measured the weight of this larger relay, it was 104 grams. Now let's weight the smaller relay. It is 151 grams. There is a difference of 46 grams between the two relays. Apart from this, there is another difference that I'll explain later. The first question is, what is a potential relay, and what does it do? A potential relay is a device used to connect the running capacitor and start capacitor to the compressor or motor. The running capacitor remains permanently connected to the motor or compressor's winding, specifically to both the running and starting windings. However, the start capacitor is only used to provide the torque needed to help the compressor or motor start. Once the starting process is complete, the start capacitor's function ends. If we want to protect our motor, a potential relay is an excellent solution. It works very efficiently and has a long lifespan. Now let's talk about its installation. If the installation is correct, it will work perfectly. Otherwise, it will fail quickly. Whenever you install it, make sure to install it vertically because it functions properly in this position. If you install it horizontally, it will fail sooner, and the connected components may also get damaged. So the rule is to always install it vertically. Now, let's look at an open potential relay to understand its points. Each relay has different numbers marked on it. Here you can see point 1, then point 2. There's no point 3 on this relay. Then we have point 5, point 6, and finally point 4. This is how this particular relay is structured. However, there are other types of relays as well. For example, this relay has point 1, point 2, point 5, and point 4. If we understand these points, we can easily understand how the relay functions. Now let's understand the mechanism and coil of this relay, how it works, and its function. You can see a tape on top, and underneath it lies the coil. Let's check where the coil's points are connected. Zooming in, you can see that one point of the coil is connected to point 5, and the other point is connected to point 2. So the coil is connected between point 5 and point 2. This is how the relay's internal mechanism is structured. The next function works like this. The starting capacitor needs to be disconnected from the system after it has completed its task. To achieve this, one point of the starting capacitor is connected to pin 1. Let me explain how it gets disconnected. When electricity flows through the coil, it creates a strong magnetic field. This magnetic field pulls a floating metal piece, which is initially held in place by a spring. As soon as the magnet is created, this metal piece attaches to it. When this metal connects to the magnet, it triggers a reaction. Two points that are normally connected are disconnected. This disconnection removes the starting capacitor from the system. In its normal state, without electricity, the points are connected, but as soon as electricity flows through the coil, the magnetic field disconnects them, effectively removing the starting capacitor from the circuit. Now, let me explain the remaining points and their functions. The 4-number pin acts as a junction point, allowing you to connect multiple electrical points together. This pin is specifically designed for this purpose. The 6-number pin is also an unused point, which can be used to connect additional points in a series. This gives flexibility for connecting other components as needed. Now, I have drawn some diagrams to explain the connections. Here's the setup. This is the potential relay. This is the compressor, and an overload protector is connected to it. We also have a run capacitor and a start capacitor. For the connections, pin 5 of the relay is connected to the neutral. Pin 4 is connected to the line. This setup forms the basic wiring for the system. Now let's complete the connections for the capacitors. Start capacitor. One terminal is connected to pin 4 of the relay. The other terminal is connected to pin 1. This completes the connection for the start capacitor. Run capacitor. One terminal is connected to pin 2 of the relay. The other terminal is connected to pin 4. This completes the connection for the run capacitor as well. Now the entire setup is properly wired and ready. Now, we need to connect the compressor or motor to complete the system. First, we'll connect the 5-pin of the relay to a common point. This point is also connected to the overload. After that, to supply power to the compressor or motor, we take direct electrical input from pin 2 and connect it to the starting point. This will allow the starting capacitor to get the necessary electric supply. Finally, for the running capacitor, we connect it from pin 4 to the running part. This completes the circuit. Now, when the system is powered on, the compressor or motor will start running. Now, let's proceed with the testing and I'll also explain the difference I mentioned earlier between a good relay and a bad relay. Both relays may function, but the quality makes a significant difference. First, let's check the points 2 and 5, as I explained earlier. When I measure the resistance between these points, I get a value of 7.9 kiloohms, which means this coil is in perfect condition. Now for the bad relay, when I check the coil resistance, I see a much higher value of 16.21 megaohms. This is a very high resistance, meaning the starting time for this relay will be significantly longer, and the function will be slower. Using such a relay can lead to system damage because it's not functioning properly, so you should minimize the use of these low-quality relays. Next, I check the continuity between pins 2 and 1. For both relays, the reading is 0.3 ohms, which indicates that both have proper continuity and are in working condition. However, the key difference is in the coil quality. The low-quality relay has a poor coil, which can negatively affect performance and timing. On the other hand, the high-quality relay has a reliable coil and will perform much better in the long run. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.